Streaming knowledge method is a method that will help you to organize ideas. Sometimes we have intuitive ideas, ideas in the mind that we need to write about or make artwork, but they are very intuitive. We don't know how to do it. We don't know how to make them concrete. It will also help you to define keywords. Keywords which you can then relate to your topic, to your subject, and can make a research in the library. If you don't have keywords, if you need to write about something, you don't know what you're going to do, go to the library, there are millions of books. Even if you narrow your subject, you then come up with shelf and shelf of books, and it's very difficult to find the relevant information. If you create keywords before you go to the library, you can make a dedicated research, search for the literature, to bring only relevant information. So it minimizes the content to search for. It also helps you to structure your article. So after you have intuitive idea, you become concrete, you have keyword, you search for your literature, you have a lot of books. How do you write an article from this? What do you do? You can use this method. Let's look at an example from a completely different world. This is from the world of art. This is an artwork, example of artwork by artist called Hanoch Piven. What he does is three-dimensional illustrations. So he would use found objects, any object he can find around him, to illustrate people, living people, real people. Now the objects have meaning. These are not just random objects. They are found objects, but he found objects which represent the people that is illustrated. For example, who do you think is illustrated here?
Jay Leno.
That's right, yeah. Jay Leno.
Oh, yeah.
That's him, he's an American TV presenter. Yeah. Now what I want to show you is that how the object, the found object, are relevant. So this is not found object, this is acrylic paint to create the background, the shape of the head. But then these are found objects. Can you see microphones here? Mm-hmm. So why would you use microphone to illustrate Jay Leno?
It's media.
Yeah, media, TV show, absolutely. So the eyebrow is made of found object, which is a microphone that he found somewhere, but it's relevant to the illustration. Pins with American flag that makes the eye, why would he use that?
He's American.
The show was in American television, NBC, I think, and perhaps he's a patriot, maybe, who knows. So relevant, not just the shape and the image, but the reason behind it. These are...
Time of Sheridan.
Exactly. So the time it was shown was 10, from 10 to midnight. And can you see these are arms from a clock, from a watch? So he took bits from a clock, from a watch, because it's a talk show. You know, in talk show you keep talking like a clock. So, relevant, meaningful objects.
Another example,
who would that be?
Barbra Streisand,
absolutely. Yeah. You can't get wrong. So, the same object, but has a different meaning now. A microphone. Why a microphone? Because she's a singer. And what else?
She's going to be recording.
Exactly. Brilliant, isn't it? So, going back to the streaming knowledge method, this is a table template that you could use. We're asking students to come up with a topic. So if you need to write something about, or if you need to create an artwork, we'll ask you to come up with a topic. And we'll ask you to do it immediately, without reading the literature, without going to the library, without asking people. We want you to come into yourself, to think about your intuition. Very quickly, something that interests you. Come up, write it as a topic. Then we'll ask you to define it. Defining something is simply saying the same thing, using different words. That's what it means. So you have a topic, then I ask you one sentence, define it. Tell me what is your topic, using different words. I'll give you an example in a second. And then we ask you for three categories, three keywords that come from your topic and represent your topic. Now, if you're doing a PhD or MA, or if you need to write a long article, you can then make subcategory and sub-subcategory, so you break each category to 3 and to 9, come up with conclusion and overall conclusion. You can do that. And this is the subject, this is the project you'll do before you go to the library. Today, we don't need to go so far. We'll focus on the topic, definition, and categories. This is a topic. I asked the student, come up with something that interests you, and he came back and he said, a chair. Great. Why chair? Because this student is interested in chair. Chair is interesting. That's what he likes to do. Research has nothing to do with the brief, has nothing to do with what I asked him to think, nothing to do with anyone. What do you like? I like chair. Great. How would you define a chair?
Very simple.
Quick, straightforward. An object used to sit on. There could be other definitions. That was his definition. Great. What are three categories of a chair? Three things that chair is made of, that constitute a chair. You can say legs, seat, and back. So if you come to me and you say Gil, object, got legs, seat and back, I will ask you, do you mean a chair? I'll probably know that you're referring to chair because categories are three ingredients of your topic. In this case, leg, seat and back. The beautiful thing is that a different student could come with completely different ideas, different categories, not legs, seat and back, but wood, nails and varnish. Because you see differently. And you say, I don't care about the legs. What interests me is the varnish, the color, the wood, the nail. That will make a completely different article, completely different artwork, using the same topic. So don't worry if you've seen someone doing the same thing. It's not going to be the same, yeah.
If the articles, if you're writing something specific to your magazine or an article,
yes,
or a research paper, there's going to be some kind of heading already within.
Exactly.
Does that make sense? So you're,
yes,
you're already going to have that without then defining it again, because it's already going to be pretty set.
Commission, someone will commission you to do a chair.
Yeah.
They will commission you, but still, the definition could be different, or at least the categories will be different.
Yeah.
So it's true, they will give you the topic when you're commissioned, so you won't be working intuitively there. However,
yeah,
there are many ways to define it and use categories.
Okay, so you come back to them with a new suggestion of categories based on your interpretation.
Absolutely, and this is what they're looking for. This is why they will pay you, because they don't know, they don't have the understanding of it. They want to see your input,
okay,
into it.
Yeah.
And someone else will give you a completely different input. One student, second student, different categories. So, let's look at this amazing work by Karim Rashid, the pyramid chair, right? Upside pyramid. So I can see the seat here, I can see the back, but where are the legs?
The stand.
The stand?
One leg.
Yeah? So this is the leg. The actual bottom bit of the seat is also the leg. Can you see it? Can you see this plate here, actually, supporting the plate to the bottom? I would say that this is the leg, really. It would be amazing if you could remove it, you know, put some heavy metal here, and we'll need that. But look at how the interpretation could be, and again, that is relevant to you. So even if two people come up with the issue of legs, you have to do legs, because they commission you to do something with legs, people can do it differently. There are many ways to go about it. So a different example, topic, tea, aromatic beverage. Someone can come up with three categories, leaves, cup, spoon, great. Someone else can say grandmother, Brighton, and seaside. It's brilliant, because when you tell them tea, they remember their visit to grandmother who lives in Brighton, and they're having tea with her on the seaside. Many ways to go about it. Now, when you do a PhD or need to create a long thesis or article, you would then create your topic, definition, categories, and you would then do your subcategories and sub-subcategories. Then you will make conclusion. Overall conclusion. If you need this template, it's online, an empty template, Word document online for this table. Once you've done this, only then you go to the library, only then you do your Google research, because now you have vocabulary, now you have keywords that are relevant to you, to what interests you, not what other people tell you. And now you simply do a key search in the catalog in the library or in Google, key search in this case for sensing and design, or do anticipation, feeling, stimulation, and design. These are the keywords that you type in and you find the relevant information. Obviously, you will be loaded with a lot of information, but then all you need to do is just to connect this word. Make one sentence that connects the word sensing with the word feeling. And this connection is based on what you find in the literature. And that will constitute your article. You already have your three chapters here. This could be chapter 1, 2, and 3 in an article. So your categories are the chapter of your articles. So, from meaningful objects, found objects, creative objects that are meaningful to the character which is illustrated, to meaningful keywords, categories, found keywords, keywords that you find in your own mind, which are relevant to you, and they are relevant to the topic. So, from art to academic world, it's the same, it's about creativity and how you channel it. Now what we're going to do, we're going to do your own streaming knowledge collage. Streaming knowledge selfie collage. Using this table. The topic is you. It's about you. So, here you write your name, just your name. Then I'll ask you to define who you are and what you are. I'll show you an example in a second. Then I'll ask you for three categories. But again, I'm giving you the categories. I'm saying the first category has to be a belief. Some belief that you have in your mind. Just write it down. memory, and a hero.
I'll show you an example.
This is me. So the topic, you write your name. Definition, if you ask me who, what am I will tell you I'm a worker of creativity of inspiration. This is my life purpose, to increase more creativity and inspiration. So I'm not talking about being an associated lecturer for the Open University. This is who I am, very intuitive. And then one, belief. I believe in this thing called oneness. I believe we're all connected. Just put it here, randomly, your belief. Memory, waves inside the sea. Just a memory that came to me when I was young. I almost drowned once when I was a child. And inside the sea, I saw wave. Nothing to do, no connection. Just put it down. A hero, Immanuel Kant, one of my heroes, a great German philosopher. Nothing to do between these three, but this is what comes to my mind. Then, the fun bit is to make a collage with these keywords. So you will create a collage, this is an example, that represents all your keywords. This is my collage. I happen to see this image here. This is just a hat hanger, coat hangers. But look, it looks like human beings. Each one is like a different person, but they're all connected. So it's like oneness, idea of oneness represented there. When I almost drowned, I remember there was a pier, it looked like that. It was like a big slip because I was like hovering inside the water. So I put a big slip. It was very calm, like pillows, but very dangerous, like this. So you just look at images and make connections. So this is my memory here. Immanuel Kant, my hero, the last category. I saw this sofa, I thought it would be great to be a philosopher sitting on such a sofa. Nothing to do with Immanuel Kant, he lived 300 years ago, but that's relevant to me. And he was talking about time, this is why I put a clock, and about space. This is why there is a lot of empty space here and here. This is my collage. It is relevant, and it answers all the categories. So you will do the same thing. So your task now is to copy this table, working individually, creating your own definition of who and what you are, making up three categories, belief, memory, or hero, and then creating collage. We have a lot of newspaper here, tearing, breaking. Once you've done your collage, also write about it. Make a short paragraph or three paragraph describing it. Because remember, you can use this method to create art, but also to write article. So we will do both.